tasting the 2007 Harewood Estate Shiraz. I like to blend Shiraz from Franklin River with Shiraz from Mount Barker. Franklin River is one of the most exciting Shiraz regions in Australia. It has a fantastic tarriness, a spicy element, lovely blackcurrant fruit, but without becoming jammy like some of the other sort of more prominent regions of Australia. Introducing the Mount Barker element to me adds a chocolatey, slightly coffee mocha character. So the combination of the two produces a very complete wine. The colour is particularly strong. Franklin River is a very dry area, so it tends to have naturally very high colour in the fruit. The aromatics really capture those characters we were talking about. There's a really, really delicious tarry, licorice, black coffee, sort of that chocolate-coated coffee bean note, black cherry, hints of blackberry, but still spicy and lifted, very, very floral nose. Tasting the wine. Very, very Moorish, very, very rich, soft. Again, that lovely mocha, chocolate, coffee bean, blackcurrant. Quite subtle tannins, so not overpowering. Good match with most foods. Nice acidity going through the wine. So again, a wine that will age nicely for up to 10 to 15 years. But again, I think really one of the strengths of the Great Southern Shiraz, particularly Shiraz from Franklin River.
This is the Castle Rock Estate 2009 Shiraz. The fruit from this wine doesn't come off our property here, but from a vineyard about 5 kilometres down the road. It's a little bit lower than where we are, so it has a nice northerly aspect and is a little bit warmer, which is really important for a red variety like Shiraz. You get nice flavour and colour intensity, and you get really good consistency from year to year, which is important. If we have a look at the colour, we can see it's a nice purple red colour with really crimson edges. On the nose we can see some nice ripe plum characters, but also some distinctive cool climate characters from the Porongups, such as black pepper and spice, and these add an extra dimension to the wine. There is also some cedary notes from the French oak, and there's some good complexity there as well. And on the palate, we have a lovely, rich front palate with a plum fruit, really filling out the mouth nicely. And then along the mid palate, we're getting spice and pepper. We're getting the cedary French oak, all adding nice layers to the wine. And that all comes together with some nice, firm, ripe tannins and good acid structure, giving us really good length and power and drive to the wine. You can enjoy this wine now, enjoy its power and intensity now, or if you cellar it, it will mellow and get some nice maturity for many years to come.
Now we are looking at Albany Shiraz. Albany Shiraz is quite unique, as it's different to the rest of Australian Shirazes because it's a medium-bodied wine. The colour is vibrant purple. Sometimes Australian Shirazes are dark to black in colour, but Albany Shiraz is this vibrant, pretty purple colour. The nose has abundant spice with undertones of black and white pepper. We get the two different pepper characters from different picking periods in the vineyard and then blending those characters once the wine has finished fermentation. The palate consists of plums, some strawberry, with undertones of blueberries, and some spice and pepper following on the late palate. It is medium bodied and suitable for short to mid-term cellaring.
This is a 2007 Block 9 Shiraz. So it's called Block 9 because it's a single vineyard Shiraz which was established in Mount Barker again, early 70s. So it has been dry grown and has been established really slowly. So now we are able to have very vital character coming out of that vineyard. So this one has a very deep red color. So every year, this Shiraz will really focus its spectrum in the blue fruit spectrum. So it's very fragrant, very fresh, but yet very very fruity. It has also a lot of very nice savory character, like tobacco leaf. Imagine you walk under a forest and you smell all these characters like wet earth, wet leaf, tobacco leaf, humus. It has all these very savory characters which enhance the primary spectrum, which is focused around the blue fruit. On a palate, this one is very Shirazi, which I mean like that, and it's very round and very full. And this one has been aged into oak between 16 and 18 months. And the oak character have really integrated and really giving this one extra characters and extra structure. So it's quite framed in a way, but yet the middle palate is so rich and textured and you don't really feel the difference. So it's a very full wine.
So this is our Franklin Estate Isolation Ridge Vineyard Shiraz. And the Shiraz in the Franklin River Appellation is certainly a wine and a varietal that's becoming very well recognised around Australia and certainly the world. Shiraz in the Appellation maintains this lovely medium-weighted style, but is packed full of flavour and intensity. And I think that's what's giving this varietal such recognition. Isolation Ridge Shiraz. Lovely dense colour, red brick, brooding plum, almost sanguine in its texture and colour. On the nose, you just lots of black pepper, spice, lovely intensity to this wine, and already you can smell that there's going to be some considerable weight and complexity. Our Shiraz, like our Cabernet Sauvignon, in fact, all of our red wine spends about 18 months in French oak, and we believe this contributes to the complexity and texture of the wine. On the palate, again, lovely spicy notes from this Shiraz varietal, and I think that's what the region is becoming very well known for, this black pepper, spice, and again, lovely, rich, generous fruit. And depending on the season itself, we say in the Franklin River region, you can go from black pepper and dense spice notes to, in cooler years, a white pepper and lighter spice. But typically, a very consistent style of Shiraz, and this middle weightedness or full flavour, but middle weightedness is what is giving our Shiraz certainly strong recognition around the world.
Okay, Butterfield beef ribs, braised in a very light spice of star anise, cassia bark, braised for about 6 hours, and that's served with wok fried potato and peppered onions, and finish it off with some snow peas. The sauce is obviously the beef choux that's come out of the beef, and again just very light on the spice but aromatic to work with the beef. And the beef should be quite silky and smooth. I've left a fair bit of fat on there just to make sure the meat stays nice and moist.
Beautiful meat that's just got lovely flavour, and then the star anise that's been put on top of it to
go with it enhances the meat, but it also, I think, brings out the pepper and spice characters of the Shiraz as well. And I think they really do come together really nicely. Yeah, the Shiraz has got sort of not huge tannins, so that sort of sits really nicely in the mouth.